My heart that seemed a bird was gliding in the sun, and joyous, free about the rigging, swerved at play. The ship, too, like a sun-drunk angel flown astray, under the clear blue, happily skimmed on and on. What is that somber island like a low, dark wall? Cythera, someone says, a country famed in song, trite Eldorado of bachelors no longer young. Look, it is only an arid country after all. Island of magic love rites and sounding lyre, shore of delicious secrets. Like a fragrance there, the shade of Venus glides upon the sea-washed air, drugging the very soul with languor and desire. Fresh myrtled island, garden still unwithering, your long renown by every human tongue confessed to the far-scattered nations of east and west, diffuses like the incense of full-blossomed spring, or a dove's endless cooing. Cythera was no more than a terrain of rock and scrub, a dismal reach of emptiness disturbed by an occasional screech. I saw one curious object, though, along that shore. It was no vine-girt temple where, with vague desire, robe loosened to the breezes, the young priestess went among green arbors, mingling with the rose's scent, that of her pulsing body and its secret fire. No. But we did see, following the coast so near that frightened birds were scolding and beating upon our sails, a solitary gibbet with three branching rails against the sky like a black cypress, sharp and clear.